Hi everyone. In this video, I'll be showing you how to capitalize and update the values present in a column in MySQL. So let's get started. So what I meant by capitalizing and updating the first letter of a word is, so here I'm having a column named as name call, and I'm having some string or varchar over here. So all the first letter or small letters for hello, world, and hi encoding. So by running this particular command, what will happen is that the H for hello will be capitalized, W for world will be getting capitalized, and H for hi will be capitalized, and at the end it will also get updated in the table itself. So it's just like capitalizing the first letter and updating the value. So let me just now close this. So for this we will be using this particular command. Okay, so first let me just copy paste this command, and later I will explain you what I am doing. So I'll just copy this and I will just now paste it over here. So it's going to be update your table name. Test table is my table name over here. So you need to have your table name. So update table name, set column name. So this is the column where you want to capitalize the first letter and update it. So name call is a column that I want to like capitalize the first letter. Name call, and here we will be using like four functions: concat, uppercase, left, and substring. So first let me just now break down. Okay, so what we are basically doing is we are just removing the first letter. Okay, so what this left function does is that it basically takes the first letter from a value. So I'm just having a demo over here. So this is that left function. So here you can see, right, select left MySQL of 1. So if I just now run this particular query, I'll be getting m in the output. So if I run this, so here you can see that I'm getting m. So if I just now remove m like YSQL, and if I just now run, I'll be getting y. So yeah, I'll be getting y. So this particular command just removes the first letter from your column value. Okay, so after running this command, we will be having here the first letter. So we are just capitalizing the first letter with the help of uppercase. So what this particular query does is that it just capitalizes. So let's suppose say that hello is my word. So hello, this particular thing, okay, this particular thing will be, wait a second, yeah, so this particular thing will be equal to h, small h, okay, just consider my value in the column to be as hello. So this particular command will be small h, and after that here we are using the uppercase. So if I just now copy this uppercase, it's obvious it will just convert the lowercase letter into capital letters. So this command will give us capital H, because this was small h and a closing bracket should come. So this was small h, capitalizes the small h to capital H. So that's what we'll be getting here. So this is now fine. Later I'll be coming to concat function. And here we are having substring of our column value, comma 2. So what I will now explain you what the substring and what this 2 basically does. So I'm having here another example. So the exact same thing, I'm having substring. Instead of column value, I'm having a normal string, and I'm having 2. So what this 2 basically means is that this will break this particular column value or string that we have passed, removing the first character. So comma 2 means that it will accept the substring of this string only from the second character. So it will basically neglect the first character, okay, and will consider only from the second index. So just consider m to be as 1, y to be as 2. So from 2, this is going to be the new substring which is trimmed. So if I just run this, m will be removed, we'll be having YSQL is best. So here you can say that YSQL is best, which basically trims the first letter. So exactly the same thing that we are doing here. Substring name call to, so our value is hello. So what happens, I'll just copy this now. So this is going to be equal to, as I told you, it will trim the first thing, it will remove the first thing, and it will just have the rest, okay, because our number is 2 over here. So this is going to be ELLO now. Everything in small letter, we are not converting, like capitalizing it. This uppercase only applies for the left, okay, only for H, not the rest of the words. So after this, now we will be having concat function. So inside concat, we are having this uCase function, and we are having substring. So at the end, it will be like this, concat of capital H, comma ELLO. So this is going to be of type string. Concat basically joins the particular text inside it. So at the end, this will give us hello. Okay, so our hello was fully small at first, and now the first letter is caps. So we are just setting the value. So, and then it's basically just update and set function. So update table name set column name equal to hello, H with caps. Simple. So this happens for all the column values. So this is it in a nutshell. I hope you would have really understood this. And another main thing, you need to be super, super careful with the bracket. So uppercase should completely enclose only the left function and not the substring function. This is the first parameter for concat. And this is going to be the second parameter for concat. And this substring is like independent. It is not being enclosed by anything. So this is the command. If you want, you can just like have this. Yeah, this is the command. So now let me just now show you. So if I run it normally, everything is small. The first letter is small. And if I just now copy this and run it. Yeah, I'm getting a green mark. And if I just now select and run it. Yeah, so here you can see, right, I'm getting the first letter as caps. And in case if you are finding any error, like you are not using var condition to update your particular table, what you need to do is you need to just click on edit and you'll be having the preferences option. And in the preferences, you need to go to SQL editor and scroll down. And here you will be having this safe updates, okay, rejects updates and deletes with no restriction. You need to just uncheck this. If it is checked, you need to uncheck this and you need to restart your MySQL workbench. So if you restart and try running this command, it will work perfectly now. Fine. Yeah. So this is it, guys. I hope you would have found this video useful. I have also run many tutorials in C, C++, Java, Python, Node.js, React.js, MongoDB, MySQL, CRUD operations also. So check the playlist of my channel. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.